I'm Jim Turner, and welcome to DLife TV Online. It's going to be a great show in a new place. We'll be here Sundays at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, with new shows about living your DLife. Every week, we'll be sharing insights, recipes from the DLife kitchen, stories about real people living and achieving with diabetes, and so much more. We're glad you're here. Now on with the show.
My name is Ben Gray. Now I'm a diabetic. I have type 2 diabetes. I work for the city of Chicago, and I get up in the morning, get ready, and hit the street. I didn't know that diabetes and kidney failure were like they're like hand in hand, so to speak. One will start the other to happening. Otherwise, I would have jumped on it seriously in 1992 when I first was diagnosed with it. I'd have changed my diet right away. Probably would have ate any more cookies and ice cream, and I would have went to the club more, would have dropped 20 pounds right away. A couple of years later, when things started getting worse, then I realized I got to take this thing seriously. I got to finally go on dialysis because I was at the lowest point that I could get to. My legs were swollen, my feet were swollen, couldn't get into my shoes. High blood pressure, impotence. You know, these are things that they don't tell you about, but when things start happening to your body that it's not working normally, you gotta get that checked out right away. So I kept saying, all right, I'm gonna try this a little longer to try and fight it off until I finally said, okay, set it up.
What's your goal, 5.5? You're on it for 4 hours.
Dialysis is a form of, it's like an artificial kidney in a sense. It acts and does the things that my kidney no longer does. You don't urinate the same, your body does not excrete the toxins that are in it, so once your kidney starts failing, you need this to live.
How you doing?
I come to dialysis after work.
Yeah. You got a permit?
Yeah, but I don't have it with me. I switched trucks.
Each session for myself is like 4 hours, 3 days a week. But if it means living, it's not a big deal, not a big choice to make. My doctors have, you know, your kidney is failing, and you might consider going on dialysis because eventually you will start feeling bad. And if you don't do it in time, you could die. My significant other supported me 100%, wanted to make sure that I was eating right, doing the right things, that I followed up on all the stuff that my physician said that I should do, and I should get in here as soon as I could to take care of this and also pursue a transplant. They ask for a lot of tests before you can even be put on the list, so they're not just giving you a kidney because you need one. Most of the transplant centers also want you to be in pretty good general, overall, good condition and everything else. Mikey, I think my blood pressure is getting a little low.
Is it?
The 113.
Is it?
Yeah, I don't want to have a scene here, so maybe shoot me 100. I'm very active. I question things, I ask questions, I find out, I have them explain everything to me because I want to know what's going on. A dialysis patient has to help themselves too. When they give you your labs back, which they check once a month, and they show you what's high or what's low, what you need to do, you got to get this down, you got to take care of that. And you realize you still have a chance to straighten things out and still have a pretty good life. And you start realizing how important life really is, and you got to do something.